Brown, Deputy OD.
Ciarán Cóla, I want to ask the Tánaiste, I want to request the Tánaiste's help in clearing up a lot of confusion that has now arisen amongst public sector workers in relation to their allowances. The Tánaiste will be aware that on the 19th of September, his Minister for Public Expenditure, who had targeted savings of 75 million and 1,100 allowances, announced that he could only find one allowance for existing workers out of the 1,100 that could be cancelled, and that the savings, instead of being 75 million, would be only 3.5 million. There's a huge gap there, obviously. Now, subsequent to that statement, on the 19th of September, the Tánaiste will be aware that both Impact and ICTU conveyed to the government and to the minister that there were further possibilities, that he hadn't gone far enough, he should have dug deeper, there was room for consultation, etc., and the minister indicated that he would undertake such consultation. Then suddenly, on the 28th of September, according to the date in the circular, on the 28th of September, 9 days later, the minister found that instead of cutting one allowance for existing workers, he could cut 90. That was a 9,000% improvement in 9 days. The public sector and the private sector could take some lessons from that. Now, what I want to ask the Tánaiste is three things, briefly. First of all, what procedure are the government going to adopt to reduce these allowances? Secondly, is the procedure going to be within the terms of the Croke Park Agreement? And thirdly, and most importantly, what cost, what saving does the minister now envisage getting? Because according to reports, one of those allowances that he's now proposing to cut would last year have saved the country the grand sum of €2,500. Another one would have saved less than €20,000. So is this now a genuine attempt at reform, or is it, in the words of a Fine Gael backbencher, whom I'm quoting exactly from this morning's Irish Independent, a window dressing exercise to take the heat out of the situation?
Thank you.
Well, I'm very happy to clear up any confusion in Deputy OD's mind. The allowances that we're referring to, are allowances that were agreed over the years. Many of them were agreed during the 14 years when your party was in government, when the style of public service management that was pursued by Fianna Fáil was to throw taxpayers' money at any problem that arose. Now, the position is that Minister Howland conducted an extensive review of allowances across the public sector. It's the first time that that was done. In many cases, these allowances were historically granted in lieu of pay increases and now form part of core pay. Cutting core pay is not compatible with the Croke Park Agreement. But what the Croke Park Agreement has demonstrated is that there is more than one way to reduce the public sector pay bill. By the end of this year, the public sector pay bill will have been reduced by €3.1 billion. As of last March, there were 28,000 fewer public servants than at the peak in 2008, yet frontline services are continuing to be delivered for more people. There are more school children, more hospital patients and more clients of social services. In relation to the three questions that Deputy OD asks, what procedure will be involved? The Minister has asked the individual departments to pursue the elimination of allowances with their respective staffs concerned. There are, I think, 180 allowances that are being discontinued for the future. Departments have been asked to look at existing allowances. The procedures will be that are to be followed are the industrial relations procedures that come within the terms of the Croke Park Agreement. And in respect of savings, as I've said, €3.1 billion in savings has already been achieved using the Croke Park Agreement.
Thank you. Deputy OD.
I'm sorry, the Minister didn't, or the Tánaiste didn't answer my principal question, which was savings. I mean, the Minister for Public Expenditure set out by saying he was going to save 75 million. He found on the 19th of September that he could only save 3.5 million. Now, obviously, he's found extra allowances. So how much extra saving does the Minister hope to make as a result of these newly identified allowances, which were identified in 9 days? And secondly, I want to ask the Taoiseach very specifically, is the 3,500 per annum allowance, education training allowance, payable to hospital consultants, is that going to be continued? Because I put it to you, Taoiseach, it would be perverse if it did, in view of the fact that the €16.90 per week paid to lowly paid, of an allowance paid to lowly paid paramedics is already within the Minister's sights, even though that has been ruled to be part of core pay.
As I've said, there has already been savings of 3.1 billion. Oh, hold on. 3.1 billion has already been saved on the public service pay bill. For the first time, a government is addressing the issue of allowances in the public service. Now, you had 14 years, and in that 14 years, at a time when many of these allowances could have been addressed, could have been rationalised, could have been consolidated into pay. What you did was you added to the problem. Throughout that 14 years, your style of dealing and your then leader's style of dealing with the issue of pay in the public service was every time there was a problem, you invited them in, gave them a wink, talked about public service reform, and wrote the cheque. And that's why we've ended up. That's why we've ended up with a large number of allowances which now have to be disaggregated. Some of them there is no case. Some of those allowances there is no case for. Some of those allowances are perfectly in order. Some of those allowances have effectively become part of core pay. They have to be disaggregated. And for the first time, this government is addressing the issue of allowances. And Minister Howland has already made it clear that 180 of those allowances are to be discontinued for the future. He has asked departments to look at existing allowances and to pursue those under the terms of the Croke Park Agreement. And that is part of an overall strategy at reducing the public service pay bill, which has already been reduced by €3.1 billion.